might be wondering what significance these things all have. These are things I set money aside each week as a part of my budget. It is a well-known fact that the average college student's money is tight. Today, I'm going to inform you the importance of budgeting in college, how I personally budget my paycheck, and how you can manage your money more efficiently. College students are put under an enormous amount of stress during a typical school year, between juggling 15 plus hours of classes, a job, a social life, and trying to maintain a healthy lifestyle. It's no wonder that most college students are constantly pinching their last pennies. A study conducted by the well-known author and television host, Ben Kaysom, stated that the average college student will most likely spend anywhere between $10 and $12 a day on food. This adds up to be nearly $85 a week on food alone. Now consider how costly life can be when other expenses are added to the mix. With a steady budget to rely on from week to week, you are guaranteed to know how much you are spending on each item. By understanding the value of a dollar, you are able to gain a better mindset on how important your money is. For example, if you know you only have X amount of dollars to spend in a week, you would not spend 90% of your earnings in the first 2 days and rely on the remaining 10% for the rest of the week. You would want to evenly distribute your wages throughout the week so that you can rest assured that you will have money at all times. The most important thing to know is that with every dollar you inherit, whether you work for it or it was given to you, has a place to go. You should always know that when and where each dollar is spent. In my own life, I have developed what I call the envelope system to help me budget my money in a more practical way. After I receive a paycheck every other Friday, I go to the bank and put 20% of my wages in my checking account. I rarely use my debit card as I try to use it for emergencies only. With the remaining 80%, I then cash it out and divide it evenly and place it into each amount into envelopes labeled Food Week 1, Food Week 2, Gas Week 1, Gas Week 2, Ties, Car Insurance, and Phone Bill. Utilities that I do not require to be paid monthly, such as my car insurance and phone bill, do not get their full amounts at once. Over time, I gradually add money to the envelope so that when it is time to pay the bill, I'm not using my entire check to cover the cost, and I still have money for other necessities like food and gas. Each envelope is strategically set up to last me 7 days, typically Sunday to Sunday. At the end of the week, if there's any remaining money left in an envelope, I then take the money out and put it back into my savings. This money is not for me to use into the next week, but to have for a rainy day. In order to manage your money more adequately, it is best to discover what system best suits you. A survey by Charles Schwab found that parents emphasize saving and budgeting with their daughters, but are more likely to discuss investing with their sons. You have heard it said that girls tend to be more expensive than boys, so stay mindful not only of your necessities, but what you enjoy doing for fun, such as shopping, going to the movies, or going to an athletic event. It is reassuring to know that you will have a little extra money in your bank account as opposed to having to dip out of your food envelope to pay for a movie ticket. Money can always be replaced too. If you do decide that you need to swipe your card, remember that it can easily be replaced the next time you are given money. Building up a sufficient budget is all about strategy and knowing where your priorities lie. The envelopes are there to help you physically see how much money you are allotted per week. It is important to set aside your expenses for each month, calculate your pay each week, and decide what you need to set back on and what you need for other expenses. If you thoroughly enjoy eating out and you live on campus, you might want to consider putting more money in your food envelope and less in your gas. If you're set on saving more money at a time, you could put more money in your checking and rely less on cash each week. Most importantly, stick to your budget and try not to backslide. In conclusion, learning to manage your money at an early age can only help you in your later years. According to one recent survey, 47% of college students say they rarely or never discuss budgeting with their parents before they went to college. By understanding how to place a dollar in its correct place, you can soon get into a habit of always knowing where your money goes. Today, today, I hope I have successfully demonstrated the importance of budgeting while in college and its positive long-term effects.